What kind of microscopic external parasites can you find on freshwater fish after skin scraping? And what does it look like under a microscope? In this second video, I will show you flagellates, bacteria, and spore-forming parasites. In other videos, we'll look at ciliates, crustaceans, and worms. Ichthyobodo nicator. The parasite Ichthyobodo nicator, also known as Costia, belongs to the genus Ichthyobodo, which is part of the class of Kinetoplastea, belonging to the family Ichthyobodonida. The genus Ichthyobodo includes 3 to 5 species, depending on which scientific classification is used. Ichthyobodo nicator is a dangerous fish parasite that causes mass mortality in aquariums and ponds. This tiny parasite ranges in size from 6 to 12 microns. So at 100-fold magnification under a microscope, they appear as rapidly moving large dots. At higher magnification, we can see that Ichthyobodo is flat and looks like a stretched pancake. Ichthyobodo can move in a sharply undulating or spiraling way, resembling the movement of a fishing lure. Infected fish lie on the bottom or stay near the water surface, making oscillatory movements. Fish breathe fast, press their fins against their body, while white mucus may cover the skin. The fish hardly eat and appear apathetic. Often, several types of parasites can be found in a scraping sample. Cryptobia. The genus Cryptobia also belongs to the class Kinetoplastea, but is part of the family Cryptobiida, which includes about 50 species of parasitic protozoa. The majority of them are endoparasites that live in the intestine and circulatory system of fish. 5 species of Cryptobia parasitize on the gills and skin of fish. In size, Cryptobia is comparable to Costia and at low magnification under a microscope appears as a mobile black dot. At high magnification, the difference between Ichthyobodo and Cryptobia is visible. Cryptobia have a slightly elongated shape and full body with a pointed nose, resembling mice with tails, and the parasites themselves are very pliable. The symptoms that fish exhibit are similar to those of infection with Ichthyobodo nicator. Oodinium. Oodinium is a parasitic dinoflagellate belonging to the family Oodiniaceae, class Dinophysea. Under a microscope, stationary oval-shaped Oodinium cells can be seen, which are dark brown or black in color. Members of the genus Oodinium affect both marine and freshwater species, causing symptoms that resemble an ichthyophthirous infection. The fish's body is covered with small golden-white spots, which can look like dust. Myxosporea or Myxozoa. Myxosporea or Myxozoa is a large group of spore-forming organisms, all of which are parasites, mainly of freshwater and marine fish species. The class Myxosporea encompasses several thousand species, and scientists are constantly discovering new genera and species of these parasites. For example, there are already more than 2,000 species described in the genus Myxobolus. Myxosporea have a complex life cycle, in which after several developmental stages, spores are formed in the final stage. Spores of different species have different shapes and structures. They can be round, oval, drop or heart-shaped, elongated, with spines or without. But what unites them all is the presence of 2 polar capsules containing ejector filaments. The detection of even only 1 spore in a smear confirms the diagnosis of myxosporidiosis. Parasites form cysts in various tissues and organs of the fish, where they develop and produce spores that are released into the environment. In infected tissues, we can observe nodules or granulomas, white spots, tumors, sometimes with exudate containing spores. Microsporidia. Microsporidia is another group of spore-forming parasitic organisms, of which currently about 1,300 species are known and new species are still being discovered. All Microsporidia intracellularly parasitize eukaryotic organisms. A frequently occurring disease in aquariums is Pleistophorosis, caused by Pleistophora hyphizobriconis, which affect fish of the genus Hyphizobricon, the tetrafish. Under the microscope, individual spores and cysts containing spores can be detected. Spores have a characteristic oval shape with an ejector capsule inside, which make it resemble a slipper. In affected fish, white patches form in the area of the back muscles. In these areas, the parasites develop and form cysts with spores. Flavobacterium columnare. Flavobacterium columnare is one of the few species of pathogenic bacteria that can be identified using a microscope. This large, gram-negative, rod-shaped bacterium forms colonies on the body of fish, ranging in color from white to yellow-orange, due to the pigment contained within the cells. In a sample taken from the body of an infected fish, individual scales and normal transparent mucus can be seen. But special attention should be paid to the yellow-orange film surrounding the scales, which forms bumps. At high magnification, we can observe how the shape and size of these bumps change. The undulating, bending movements of individual cells in the colony create a wave-like motion, which is the hallmark of this type of bacteria, making accurate identification relatively easy. Flavobacterium columnare excrete enzymes and other substances that are toxic to fish, leading to skin destruction and the formation of necrotic tissue. Visible signs include raised scales, accumulation of mucus and bacterial colonies in the interstitial space between scales, loss of pigment, destruction of the epidermis and shedding of scales in the affected area. We can often see a clear border between healthy and affected tissue. Did you learn anything new from this video? Please share it with your friends, leave your comments below, and most important of all, enjoy your pet fish. I'm Katya, ichthyologist and hydrobiologist at Asha Labs. Thanks for watching.